What's up, everybody? Jason here for JaspysCaseBreaks.com. 2023 Bowman Baseball Jumbo Edition 8-box case break. Pikachu's number 6 just sold out. And here we go, guys. So, here's everybody that bought in. Whether you bought in straight up or won through a filler, there you go. All teams in there. Congrats to you guys. And again, of course, fresh case. One case here. So, I'll most likely post a filler for number 7 after, of course, we get done with this. But this will keep us busy for about the next hour or so. All right, so Jumbo Edition, of course, has 8 boxes in a case for a total of 3 autos in a box. So definitely get a lot more than you would a hobby. So what I'll do here, guys, is we'll rip open the first 4, go through the cards, and then we'll rip open the next 4. one more box, and then we'll go through the first four. Here we go, guys. Oh, okay. Autograph right here. Jace Avina. /150. Dude, this guy signs it the way I sign my autograph. Holy shnikes. Well, that's supposed to be an A, but that's usually how I sign my C. I usually be signing autographs like this. Like, if I had to sign a document, I go similar. That's so funny. What's up, Aaron? Oh, because we got another Georgia Bulldog. His name happened to be DeAndre Swift. That was so funny. I had a feeling that was going to happen, though, man. When you guys drafted Jahmyr Gibbs, I think it was pretty much over for him. And the Eagles basically got him basically for nothing. Nothing. But yeah, I mean, he's always been productive. I think the problem with him was always just kind of staying on the field. He always had those little nagging injuries throughout the year. So obviously with the Eagles, I mean, I think the Eagles are looking to maybe, you know, have him to be the starter eventually. But the one thing about the Eagles offense and the Eagles just committee of running backs is that he doesn't need to be the guy, right? You're going to have him, Rashad Penny, Kenneth Gainwell, you know, Boston Scott. All those guys are going to get carries. I just think maybe later on in the year, someone is going to establish themselves eventually. You know? So, I think we did great with our running backs last year. You know? So, that's the good thing about Swift is that we don't need him to be the number one guy. All those other running backs are going to produce enough yards with our offensive line. And then the threat of Jalen Hurts, of course, running is going to obviously open it up more for the running backs again. So, but if he ends up being the guy, great. I mean, I don't expect him to be the guy until later in the season. I feel like it's going to be a committee of running backs throughout the first couple weeks, probably, until someone kind of separates themselves from the pack. But yeah, basically for nothing. Look, all those running backs we have on our roster, including Swift now, that he's only getting paid about $1 million and change, all of those guys still make about $2 million less than what Miles Sanders is making. Can you believe that? Good job for Miles getting the bag. /499, Peyton Graham. And that's that Miles Sanders is only getting paid like $6 million, dude. Imagine Zeke last year when he was getting paid like $15 million. Derrick Henry getting paid like $10 million. It's ridiculous, dude. That's how crazy the running back... market has shifted. It's just not a running back league anymore, man. You can get productive backs in later rounds and don't get paid much. You know. But at the end of the day, I mean, some running backs are still making good money. I mean, making $6 to $8 million a year is great. I mean, at least I think so. You know, but yeah, we've shifted to a defensive line, offensive line, and quarterback market, where those are the guys that are getting paid a ton. I mean, receivers also get paid kind of a ton too, but they're not nearly as much as those guys. They probably get about 15, maybe max like $20 million a year. Juan Alonso, I think it's turned into that you kind of need a really big number one receiver, or at least top two receivers on your group to be successful. Running backs, you can kind of swap them in and out all the time. Juan Alonso there for the Dodgers. Kind of caller. There was a lot of good tight ends in this draft, man. That Kincaid from Utah, he was really good. A couple of them actually fell in the second round, too. Well, I hope they win this time, Aaron. Yeah. I'm just so happy with the first two picks. I mean, just ended up doing really well in the draft. And overall, I think we've got another nice DB as well in round two and three. Jacob Berry, well, more like a round three, actually, because they traded out of the second round. Almonte to 125. Oh, I didn't even see the Dolphins draft much, Brandon. They didn't have a first round pick this year, right? Is that who they drafted in the later rounds? Tommy Speck? That's right, right? You guys got your first round pick taken away. George Burgos to 50. But a Braylon Tavera to 75, yellow. So game six for the Maple Leafs and Lightning starting right now. They're doing the national anthems. Do the Lightning push it to game seven again? Or do the Leafs finally break that hump and win a clinching playoff game, playoff series, and advance to the second round. I think it's been like 13 years since that's happened. My Kings play later tonight. They're looking, of course, to push it to Game 7. Hopefully that happens. But this is the game I'm eyeing right here, man. This is a big game right here. I don't know if Toronto wants to even go back to Toronto for Game 7 after leading the series 3-1. Again. Drew Gilbert to $3.99. Nice speckle there. Holland Palouse to $2.99 for the Oakland A's. Riley Green to $2.99. Juan Alonso to $125. Alright, two more boxes here, guys, and then we'll rip the next four. Speckle Nelson Rada for the Angels. Marcus Lee Sang. and Nick Lauf to 250. San Diego Padres going to Travis. Matt Mervis to 125.
Question real quick.
Yeah, what's up?
Do you remember hitting a Drew Jones auto for Jake Smith on IG on Wednesday?
I didn't hit him a Drew Jones.
Yeah?
I didn't hit him one.
Okay.
Not for Jake. I hit a Drew Jones here.
Yeah, that's what I thought.
No,
and that's the only one you pulled on Wednesday, right?
I know Teddy hit one on Wednesday. You should ask him.
Okay.
Yeah, yeah. I didn't hit one over there. I hit one over here, though. Morabito. Alrighty, guys. Last box, and we'll go up the next four. Luis Garcia to $4.99. Miguel Blayes to 175. Ivan Herrera to $3.99. And Randy De Jesus to $1.89. Wow. And a Angel. Gianna? Gianna? That is number 150 for the Guardians. Guardians is Rick Thomas. Ronnie Simon is 250. And Tavares for the Braves. Alrighty guys, let's go with the next four boxes here. Thank you. Alright, one more box, guys. Also, too, guys, just a little FYI, Nick took out 9 spots in that Bowman random player jumbo break. So it may look like it's down to like 2 or 3 left, but he's creating a filler right now, guys. So I think we did pretty well trying to sell it out straight up, but kind of got stuck a little bit. So we're going to do a 9-spot filler for that. So it may look like it's close to selling out, but we're going to put up that filler very soon, guys. Oh wow, what a save. Alright guys, here we go. And Paco Grego. for the Phillies to 150. Phillies is David. Jordan Walker to 150, Atomic. Paper Jason Dominguez to 250. Christopher Morrell. Payne Graham to 150 Shimmer. Troy Johnson, or Johnston, to $4.99 for Miami. So that's a hit for Miami Marlins that's going to Travis with the Miami Marlins. So there should be one more autograph, I feel like. I feel like we're still missing one more. So let's see where this is. Last one hiding. There it is, Samuel De La Rosa for the St. Louis Cardinals. That is Travis again. Nice, Travis. Henry Davis to 250. Nice, Jackson Holiday. Number to 99 for the Baltimore Orioles. That is Rob. There you go. Diaz de la Cruz to $3.99. Beckel De La Cruz. Damon Keith to 100 Atomic for the Dodgers. Dodgers, that's Bryson. Corbin Carroll. And Samuel De La Rosa. Marcos Cabrera. All right, here we go. Two more boxes, guys. Spencer Jones to $3.99. That's nice. Yankees, that's Mark. Another Luis Garcia refractor. Blue Jays, that's Neil. Juan Alonso to $3.99. Wow, Samsonov is making some monstrous saves in this game so far. Ooh, we got a red. Manuel Beltre to $5. That's for the Toronto Blue Jays, Neil. There you go, man. Nice little red right there. Now, it's not related to Adrian, right? I'll take a red, though. Back-to-back hits there for the Blue Jays. And then Simon Woods Richardson, pink, is there to 175. Marcelo Mayer to 499. Jackson Chirio and Ballesteros for the Cubbies. Chicago Cubs, that is EA. Alright, last final box, guys. Here we go. Tamar Johnson to 199. Yainer Fernandez to 150, color match blue for the Dodgers. We have to 125, Dylan Lesko. Javier Osorio. Corey Seager to 299. And Emmanuel Bonilla. This is another really, really young prospect. Just like freshly turned 17 back in January. Born in 2006. Which is wild. Marcelo Mayer to 399. Thank you. Cleveland Guardians auto to $4.99. Guardians, that is going to Rick Thomas. It should have, Josh. Joe's the one that did that on Thursday. We didn't break any jumbo yesterday. So, if you don't see it, that means Joe must have forgot. Or something happened, I guess. I can double check right now. Alrighty, guys. So, let's do a quick autograph recap. So, there you go. Guardians there. There's Vanilla. Oh, you got it? Okay, perfect, man. No worries. Bonilla, Ballesteros, Fernandez, Garcia. We did get a red Manuel Beltre to 5, which is really nice. Keith Atomic, De La Rosa, Jackson Holiday to 99 was cool, green grass. Grego, Johnson, De La Rosa again, Tavares, Luna Angel there, Garcia, Morabito, Rada, Padres, Nick, Palouse, Tavera, Speck, Barry, Alonzo, and Jay Savina. So there was all the autos there, guys. Yeah, and Drew Jones is hiding, guys. So we do have another filler up there for Pikachu number 7. If you guys want to try that tonight again, JaspysCaseBreaks.com, guys. Thanks.